The Hillsborough mansion murder case shocked the Bay Area. A young, wealthy woman from China living in a mansion with her boyfriend, both now charged with murder in the death of her former boyfriend, the father of her two children.
Tonight, a man also charged in the case has given an exclusive interview to the ABC 7 News I-team, and Dan Noyes is here with a stunning interview. Yeah.
Oh, Kristen and Dan, this case made headlines after murder suspect Tiffany Lee and her family posted a record bail, $65 million in cash and real estate. Now her former friend and alleged accomplice is talking to me from jail, saying he wants to make a deal with prosecutors.
I met 42-year-old Olivier Adela at San Mateo County Jail, but had to settle for a phone interview because of the jail's long-standing policy banning cameras.
You may start the conversation now.
Hello.
Hey, Olivier. He told me Keith Green and Tiffany Lee knew each other for years, had two children together, and the problems began when Kaveh Bayat entered the picture.
Kaveh was Keith Green's friend, right?
Yes, he met Tiffany through Keith Green, and he went behind Keith Green and brainwashing Tiffany, take Tiffany from Keith Green, making Tiffany kick Keith Green out of the mansion, moving in, make Keith Green's daughter call him daddy, and him and Tiffany only together for 6 months.
Adela told me he worked as a bodyguard and trainer for Kaveh Bayat and Tiffany Lee. February of last year, he said they invited him to the Hillsborough mansion for a meeting in the basement, the man cave as seen in these court exhibits obtained by the I-team, and the Bayat told him to leave his phone outside, patted him down, and made an offer.
I want to you to get rid of Keith Green. I said, what do you mean, rid of Keith Green? Kaveh's the one who was talking. He wants you to pretty much kill Keith Green.
Adela talked to detectives for hours, his story a central part of the preliminary hearing earlier this year. I read the 830-page transcript.
How much did they offer to pay you to kill Keith Green?
$50,000.
Adela says he refused. As the months passed, prosecutors say cell phone records show tensions grew between Tiffany Lee and Keith Green over child custody and support. One text shows Green, an aspiring chef, wanted the new BMW Tiffany had purchased, $4,000 a month, and $20,000 for furniture. I do want to create a life that is parallel to yours with the kids. Tiffany forwarded that exchange to Kaveh Bayat, who answered, he was trying to work you for money again. That's all he wants. It's not about the kids. She answers, I know. Okay, so never mind. Green light. Prosecutors allege that meant green light for murder.
Kaveh called me when I was getting ready to go through Jimmy's.
The evening of April 28, 2016, Adela told me Bayat asked him to go to the Millbrae Pancake House, where Tiffany was meeting Keith Green in her gray Mercedes G-Wagon.
They was there, so I called him. I said, yeah, you're right. They're here. There's nothing going on. They're sitting. They're not kissing. They're riding inside the car. Nothing going on.
After about an hour, Tiffany and Keith pull away. The Mercedes caught on traffic camera. That's Olivier Adela following in his Chrysler 300. He turns off and goes home, but records show the signals from Tiffany Lee and Keith Green's cell phones travel from Millbrae south toward her mansion in Hillsborough. Prosecutors say investigators found gunshot residue in the garage on this golf bag, Green's DNA on the floor and on the door sill of the Mercedes. Cell phone records pick up showing three signals heading back north from the mansion for Tiffany Lee, Keith Green, and Kaveh Bayat. Olivier Adela says he was shocked to see them arrive at his apartment.
So they pull up the car, the Kaveh was on the back seat, Tiffany was on the front seat, and Keith Green was on the front seat. Keith Green was dead.
Adela told police Kaveh Bayat lifted his shirt to reveal a black handgun.
So he told me, I did what I have to do. It's time to pull up your weight.
Adela said Tiffany watched as he and Bayat stripped Keith Green's body and put him in Adela's trunk.
Why take off his clothes?
No, it's very simple because I don't think Kaveh was satisfied on killing him. He looked like Kaveh was wanted to humiliate Keith Green.
Adela told me he worried about his girlfriend and child in the apartment upstairs, so he agreed to dispose of the body. On the way, he tossed Keith Green's cell phone in Golden Gate Park.
As you're heading north in your car with Keith Green's body in your trunk, what's going through your mind?
What's going through my mind? Well, you're black man in America, my friend, you're cool. You get rid of the body, you're cool. You don't get rid of the body, you're cool.
He found a turnout off 101 near Hillsborough and rolled the body out. For 2 weeks, friends searched for Keith. Finally, a sheriff's deputy found his body badly decomposed. The coroner determined he died from a gunshot the weapon placed in his mouth before firing. A SWAT team raided the Hillsborough mansion, arresting Tiffany Lee and Kaveh Bayat. They picked up Olivier Adela at his apartment, charged them with murder. They've all pleaded not guilty. Adela now wants to testify for the prosecution in return for reduced charges.
So the DA offered me the deal, and without me, they can't get Tiffany, they can't get Kaveh.
Time ran out on the phone call from jail.
Are you going to take the deal and agree to testify against Tiffany and Kaveh?
Yes, yes,
Goodbye.
Yes.
But prosecutors tell me there is no deal at this point, and that they are confident they can make a strong case against all three defendants, even without Adela's testimony. Lee and Byatt's attorneys tell me Adela can't be trusted, that he's a liar, and one goes so far as to call him the killer. So this is really going to be playing out in the courts as the weeks and months go on.
What a story.
Oh, thank you.
Amazing stuff. Thanks, Dan.